Okay, it's AK time, I think. Mow them all down! Oh yeah, this is where the AK comes in handy. You guys said the AK sucks. Yeah, that's a lie. Hello everybody, we're back to another video. Today, we return. We've been on the mini bike, going back. We're going back home, baby.
I'm coming home, coming home.
I don't know, I'm not gonna sing, but welcome back. Today, we return, and hello, Wolfie. Actually, no, I'm not gonna kill you. I said I wanted to beat, I don't wanna mess with the wolves. I'll go hunting for some deer. But screw the wolves. The wolves are mean, and oh my god, is that a giant ramp we could go off of? That legitimately looks like a giant ramp. I know it probably isn't, but still. Anyways, today we return, and that is the promised land. Ladies and gentlemen, I almost ran over a rabbit. But ladies and gentlemen, we haven't been here. God knows how many episodes. 30? 40? I don't know. It's definitely a lot of episodes. Here's the winding road up. This is gonna be like an entirely new town to me because it's been so long. I've totally forgotten what the hell this is like. And honestly, I am excited to see what we're gonna get. Because if you guys remember, last episode we got the 44 freaking Magnum. Okay, that's amazing. I still can't believe we got our hands on that. Along with that, I asked you guys to try to name some of the towns that we've been in. You guys, still free to do that if you want. I have not picked any official names, for any of the towns. The towns being what I'm calling Old Town, New Split Town, and Split Town, or something like that. The main towns we've been to. But anyways, today we came here, A, to revisit, see if we forgot anything behind, but B, there is a quadruple freaking gun store here, and a little pill store, I guess, you know, a little... It's a really little store by every means of your imagination. But over here, we got a quadruple gun store. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a lot of guns. And me, being Papa Star, I like some guns in Papa Star's hands. So, we are gonna roll back home. There it is. Home sweet home. After we hit some cinder blocks. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Look at that beautiful parking job. That's how you park, ladies and gentlemen. On top of a pile of cinder. But yeah, look at this. Look at how basic, look at how primitive our defenses used to be. Now, we got that. We got that as our defenses, not the sign. We literally have auto turrets protecting us. We have came so far. And it feels so good. And I hear a fire. I wonder what that is. Ooh, beer. I like beer. I'll take the beer. I'm not taking the other stuff, but I'll take the beer. Ooh, gun store box. Hello, pistol receiver. I'll try and sell you for a nifty little profit. Don't you worry. Hello. We got the Magnum, so... Oh, you know we gotta put it to use when we can. It never gets old. What's in there? Hello. Those are worthwhile. Paint? Who the hell sells paint in a gun store? I'm not trying to paint my Magnum in like a rainbow sunflower pattern. What is this shenanigans? This is communist propaganda. That's what it is. Propaganda of Popeye variety. No good. But we got a couple more stragglers chilling out and about here. Got a couple cardboard boxes. I also realized that box probably just said cardboard box, but still. Brain Bastion! Oh, look at that. She went out quietly. That's how she would have wanted to go out. This raw iron. Why do I have 8 raw iron? I might drop that or something. Bookcase, anything good? A fox painting, or however the hell you pronounce that. Another guy? Another dead guy? Well, he was actually a dead guy to begin with, but you know what I'm talking about. Dude, it's been so long. We've never relooted this old town. Once we left this place, we never looked back. We're like, yeah, we're done with that place. I'm gonna leave the white tank because it's a little bit better quality. Actually, it's about the same quality. But the white tank's got some more insulation. And considering the fact that we live in a freaking desert right now. Oh, the trees grew so well. But considering the fact that we live in a freaking desert, I'm gonna have to pass on that. As you guys can see, though, we have not a lot of stuff. I'm actually gonna start scrapping some of this iron. I'll just scrap all this jazz and get like one giant iron. Ooh, I'm burping, baby. Get one giant iron store going. We got a little bit of gold. A little bit of gold never hurt nobody. Got a little bit of paint that I ain't gonna take. And a crappy wooden door. And a whole ton of dirt. We got so much stuff, man. Speaking of things we got, you know what I hope that we got? I hope that you got yourselves an absolutely fan-freaking-tastic day so far, as always. Wishing you guys nothing but the best. There's some tallow here we could take, but nah. I guess there wasn't a lot back here. There are some trees we could chop down for wood. Honestly, kind of tempted by it. Eh, to hell with it. We got some room for it. We'll pick up some pine cones while we're at it. It's a win-win. I think it's a win. We're getting like 10 wood per hit too, so this is a solid amount. But yeah, I'm wishing you guys nothing but the most fan-freaking-tastic day in the world. As always, I hope your day is going nothing but amazing. If it's not going amazing, hey, I hope... Oh, look at that tree topple. Dude, I wish it toppled over the roof. That would have been cool. But even if it's not going amazing, I hope something changes. Maybe this video, maybe something else going on changes that makes it amazing. And if not, I hope tomorrow will be a more fan-freaking-tastic day. Whether that be through tomorrow's videos, or maybe whatever shenanigans is going on today, disappearing, whatever it is, as always, I'm wishing y'all nothing but the best. In exchange, I hope that you guys are wishing me nothing but the best, because we're going to be cutting today pretty close. Listen, we have a lot of stuff at our disposable. That didn't make English, but we got a lot of stuff, a lot of disposable stuff at our disposal. That's what I was trying to say. And what I'm saying here is that we might be a bit more adventurous during the nighttime than we usually are. I know, so you're thinking, Star, oh, savagery. Ooh, we almost forgot that. We almost forgot that, baby. Oh my god, hold on, we gotta reassemble this. I don't care that that's a little bit broken. That is a really high quality barrel. Oh mama. Yeah, I'll leave behind that schematic. Hello, long barrel. You two can get scrapped. We're getting some good stuff right now. I like this. But anyways, let's probably start putting on the flashlight. It's getting a little bit dark. Let's hop back on the bike of the miniature variety. I love my miniature variety bike. And what we should be able to see here is, oh, check it, baby. This is the quadruple gun store. So gun store number one, right there. Gun store number two, right there. Shotgun Messiah. Shotgun Messiah over there. As you can see, there's a lot. There's a lot of places, and I love them. Because you know what we're going to do? We're going to loot all of them. That's right. We're going to loot all of these gun stores. We're starting with the Shotgun Messiah, though. This place is going to have the best stuff. Like I said, it's going to be a bit more risky. We haven't dealt. This is the first time we're really going to be dealing with some stuff during the nighttime, so could be sketchy. However, nighttime is not yet, though. The nighttime is coming, but it hasn't occurred yet, so we could still potentially kill everyone before anything bad happens. But listen, worst case, I'm not that scared. You know why? We're tough. We ain't pansies. We ain't pansies out here. We ain't out here picking pansy flowers. Pansies are a type of flower, right? Something like that. We ain't out here doing that. We're out here picking violent flowers or anti-zombie flowers. Oh, yeah, we're really good at picking those anti-zombie flowers. You see what we did to his face? That could be your face. That's what happens if you don't like the video. No, just kidding. I'll never smash your face in for not liking the video. Don't worry, fellas and fellers, which is the female version of fella. I don't care what you say. Fellers is the female version. Oh, headshot, baby. That is the female version to me. Oh, no. Oh, do you see him spazzing out? He's just like, ah, the star has come. He's threatening people. Yeah, I'm threatening you. Oh, that's right. You on the ground. What you gonna do now? Boom. Oh, gonna break your neck. Son, looking like that one dude who sang that song about breaking necks. What is it? What's that guy? He's the really well-known rapper. Maybe you know him. I don't know. Hello, Sniper Rifle Barrel. That's an improvement. We haven't... Hello. Okay, we're actually taking... Oh, dude, this is... Okay, you know what we gotta do? We gotta head back to the mini bike. We gotta drop a couple things off, because check this out. The benefits of being rich and having a mini bike, right? The benefits are we can store stuff inside of the mini bike. I know. It seems like heresy to me too, but look at all that juicy mini bike storage just for the stupid crap that we call ours. Mm-hmm. We might be selling some of this crap. We might not, but I'll totally empty out my inventory, to be honest, but we gotta be ready. If nighttime comes, if things start getting bad, the shotgun rain will have to come out in full effect. As you guys know, shotgun rain is something with a very high potential of death to any who oppose it. So those of you, I've seen some comments, maybe not in 7 days. You guys here, you guys are children of the shotgun rain. I'm the messiah of shotgun rain, and you guys are my disciples, right? But listen, over there in that Last Day on Earth series, right? Not everyone has fully converted to the truth. Where the hell did you people come from? You were not all here. All right, well, I gotta start killing you too. No shotgun rain for you. You don't deserve to be converted to death by our baby, our bebe, the shotgun rain. But as I was saying, I'm gonna grab all that. Hello there, person who walks strangely. Like I was saying though, you guys here, you guys are loyal disciples of Shotgun Rain. You understand Shotgun Rain. You understand why It is such an important faith. But in Last Day on Earth, you know, sometimes when I was whipping out the Last Day on Earth over there, they didn't understand quite as well. So maybe some of you guys on occasion could check out that Last Day on Earth series. I think you might actually like it if you haven't checked it out yet. It's kind of like 7 Days to Die on mobile. It's not like a one-to-one copy, you know, but it really feels like a little bit like 7 Days to Die. And I've heard some people say, hello, baby, where were you hiding? Ah, Jesus, where the hell? They keep respawning on me. Like, what is going on, dude? I gotta take you people out before nighttime comes, because, oh, she's there too. Yeah, listen, nighttime's here, so I'm gonna start having this out and about. Oh God, hello, friend. Boop. Oh, I gotta reload. Ah, flee. I was not ready to dish out the shot. I wasn't ready. I didn't aim well enough. Shotgun rain. Ooh, yeah. You are death by AK. Yeah. Yeah. Ooh, I love using the AK every once in a while. People were hating on it. Like, Star, the AK ain't even that good. Not with that attitude, girl. Not with that attitude. It ain't good. You've seen my attitude, though. Listen, I think some AK drizzle. That might be the secondary messiah of our shotgun rain faith. Like I was saying, yeah, over in Last Day, they don't believe in the shotgun rain messiah as much. I even saw a couple comments saying, does anyone else think shotgun rain's annoying? When I read that, I was like, oh, gasp. I couldn't believe the words that had entered my ears. That those words were wrong. Those are words that should never be spoken, regardless of context. Never. See you later, cornmeal. Give me some real stuff. Hello! That'll sell for a pretty penny. I would not mind 3 stacks. Stacks. Good thing is, too, with this gun store, I think our inventory is going to be full before we can loot it. Good news is, I think there's a trader right there. So we got an easy pit stop. You know, whatever we don't like, because we came here, we're going to walk out of here with some good things, like sniper rifle stuff. If we get any AK stuff to make that better, too, that's going to be really good. Like I was saying, all the other stuff, that's just cash in the bank, boy. And our bank's already thick with like 5 C's. Our bank is thick. That's a lot of C's. It's a lot of C's. But yeah, back to the more urgent topic at hand. Non-believers of shotgun rain. Listen, maybe they'll come over. Maybe they'll understand why shotgun rain is so amazing eventually. But I am just so thankful for you guys in this series where shotgun rain is a lot more common. You understand why shotgun rain is our messiah, and stay the hell down. Oh no. Boop. Stop running at me. Oh God, we've awoken the storm. They're gonna be running out at me soon. Yep. Boop. Don't hit me. Boop. Okay, they're dead. There we go. Oh, I forgot the most important part. Shotgun rain. I know that's a waste of a shotgun shell, but listen. Alright, we gotta make sure that we are preaching while we're killing with the shotgun. Otherwise, the shotgun rain gods might come back and be like, Star, you are not a loyal disciple of our rain. And I'll be like, no, please, I am. Trust me. Yeah, I wish I could have taken this with us. Oh no, that's just the bodies breaking. It always sounds like it's a zombie attacking something, but it never is. It's weird. These gun store boxes, hello! That'll sell for a pretty penny. And 15 shotgun shells. Ooh, that won't sell, but that will sell. Oh my God, dude, we're finding some good stuff. We might need to leave some stuff behind. Hello, SMG parts. You're usually not the easiest to find. Yeah, we might need to start scrapping some. Maybe I'll scrap that. That's short sawn-off shotgun stuff. Sawn-off shotguns suck, so it doesn't matter. But whatever here is worth the least, I'll start scrapping, trying to conserve a little bit. Yeah, hunting rifle I could scrap. That we are taking. And I guess we could take the shotgun stock. That's pretty good. Is it better than our shotgun stock, actually? It is! Let's make some improvements, and then we can scrap the older one. Dude, our shotgun, if we find a purple stock, we're gonna have really close to a perfect shotgun. I don't know about you guys, but a perfect shotgun, that is a really nice ring to it. I'm liking what I'm hearing, but what I'm theoretically hearing in my head. We have a lot of crushed sand back at home. I'm keeping the stone. Stone's not the easiest thing to keep around. I'll eat up some salmon. I think we're a little bit hunger. I'm hunger. We'll eat up a little bit of that. We'll throw it out. Maybe the blood bags too. Yeah. We gotta really start being a little more conservative here. We even took some health damage, so yeah, blood bags are perfect. We will become the vampires now. Bleh! I am Count Dracula, Star. And I will suck your blood. Da. Oh god. Oh god, no! Flee! That's a giant horde coming in the middle of the night. Not trying to deal with that. Nope, 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 nope. To safety. I don't know where safety is. It's not there. Okay, actually it might be once I deal- Boop! Oh no. Boop! Oh Jesus! Did you see that zombie 360? Zombie death. Okay. Now that surprise attack has been taken care of. Oh, it has not been taken care of. It's about to be though. Oh, yeah, he's feeling good, buddy? Yeah, he's feeling good. God damn. Oh, no, they're still running at us. Boop. That was... Boop. Oh, God. We gotta take out a horde in the middle of the night. Nothing like a nighttime horde attacking us. Yo, I don't think they understand that we're here. They're gonna run past us. Perfect. As long as they don't notice us, I'm fine with that. Go on, children. Run, my children, run! Let me go back to getting guns so I can continue shooting your brothers and sisters in the face. See, if they weren't zombies out of context, that would sound awful. Make me sound like I'm a child murderer. I'm not, though. Alright, I'm only a zombie murderer. A highly qualified one at that. Speaking of that, with how powerful this magnum is, I think we gotta think of some sort of No! Why did you spawn right there? Oh god, big hit. Yeah, 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 big hit. Why did they spawn? Did you see that? They spawned right on the porch. Oh my god, that dude jumped off the roof to get to me. Why do we have to deal with you guys in the middle of the night? Oh no. Oh, big hit. That wasn't even in the face. Oh god, we gotta reload. Gotta reload. Ow! I'm bleeding? Are you serious? I don't have a lot of band-aids or nothing, so... This guy's head bobs too much. Oh god, they're all coming for me. This is why I hate nighttime. Oh my god, she's a quick one. Oh my god, there's a bigger horde coming, isn't there? I hope we got the stamina to keep running, because, okay, it's AK time, I think. Mow them all down! Oh yeah, this is where the AK comes in handy. You guys said the AK sucks. Yeah, that's a lie. Okay, you're dead. Oh god, we gotta reload. Ah, it does suck! Why am I still bleeding, by the way? I have way too much blood. Oh my god. I know this is a waste of ammo. We kind of got ourselves in this situation, to be fair. Okay, he's definitely dead. How are we still bleeding? Dude! This is insane! How hard did that zombie cut us? We gotta get to a pill store or something. Do I have cloth? How are we still bleeding? This is awful. This is really bad. This is real. Okay, thank god it stopped. Let's continue looting this place. But you know what I was saying before the whole zombie horde thing happened? If even more zombies respawn in here, I will rage quit. Okay, good. 7 days wants me to keep playing it, at least. Or does it? I don't even know at this point, man. I don't know at this point. But maybe if I get a good sneak attack in on her? Oh no, stop. Don't start wandering. Don't start wandering. You don't want to start wandering. Why are you doing that? Why? Did you sense me? Do you smell me? Oh god, stay away, stay away. Ah, no, not more blood! Not more blood! Shotgun! I'm out of ammo for the shotgun, I'm gonna die. Are you serious? No, 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 I'm not about to die. I am not gonna- No! 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 Crap. Now, you know what makes that really bad? A... I feel all- that's- why- I got too cocky, man. I didn't think that anything bad could happen. Now we gotta respawn all the way- this is awful! You know how long that run's gonna be? Oh my god. That's really bad. Cause our bed is over here. You know where over here is? Really far from over there. That's the right- and our mini bike's over there! Are you serious? Dude, I should've- okay. Future note, whenever we do anything like that again, at the very least, I am going in out. Of course the cacti gods poop on me too. They're trying to like stab my feet and stuff. God damn it, man! Are you serious? That really sucks. Stay away from me, zombie. I'm not in the mood to deal up with your antics right now. I'm back at home. I don't have any sources of light. Alright, it's really dark, and I feel bad because I can't fix this for you guys. But listen, we gotta go back there. We gotta start that journey soon. This is really annoying. Here's a problem. How the hell, what? We have no ammo. We have nothing. I think we brought everything with us. We might have some 9mm somewhere. Don't tell me I brought that with us too. No way. There's no way I brought the 9mm. But looking at it, yes way, there's a way. Okay, well, really? Zombies are attacking my base now? Yeah, I made a big boo-boo. I apologize for that. From now on, I will always put down a sleeping bag whenever we go there. Of course, dude, you guys saw that. Zombies respawned in that gun store 4 different times. She sensed me for no reason. 7 days just hit us with the biggest layer of shenanigans I've ever seen in my life. There's the ammo I was talking about. That right there is what we're taking on our journey, ladies and gentlemen. It's gonna be a journey full of zombies, probably, but to hell— oh, can I put the— I think I know what I'm gonna do here. Yeah, I know it's gotta be done. I can equip this thing with the flashlight, am I right? Yep, we can do that. And voila! Our pistol has a flashlight, at least. That's a good start! Okay, zombie, you have to shut up, my dude. I get it. You're annoyed, you're anxious with stuff, but I don't want to hear it. I don't. Okay, thank you. You stopped talking. It's exactly what Papa Star wanted. Yeah, looking at our inventory, though, there's nothing else. If we go with this, we'll set off now in the middle of the night. And it'll be a very sketchy journey to get there, but hey, it's better than no journey. And look at this. This is actually kind of cool. Get out of here, zombie. Are you serious? Why is everyone trying to attack me now? Headshot, suck it. Good thing we have such a great pistol we didn't take. This is our backup plan, baby. Operation Saving Star from himself. Kind of, in like a weird way. Ooh, we have ammo. We could make more ammo. Although I don't think we need more. We have 220 bullets. If anything, do I have any beer? Because I require lots of the beer liquids. Because we're going to be running for a hell of a long time. And maybe some water too. Are we? If we're thirsty, I'll take water like right now. We're a little bit thirsty, okay. It says a long journey ahead of us, fellas and fellers. Because we made a boo-boo, that's why. Note to you guys, I'm not taking the rocket launcher. I know some of you may have pointed that out, but like, Star, you also have the rocket. I ain't that crazy. Now, there's the bad part where, you guys remember on the way there, if you guys watched the end of last episode, there was also some zombie bears along the way to you know, that place. The good news is our wellness was really high. We haven't been really upping our wellness lately, but it was really high, so that's good. We need to get some first aid. Did we not have— I'm taking band-aids, that's for sure. I'm taking medical supplies this time. I know I had a really full inventory when I died. The good news is, like I said, there's a trader there. Hopefully by the time we get there, we're ready to roll. But for now, I'm bringing every sort of medical supply I can bring, baby. Maybe a melee weapon too. What's better? A machete? Iron reinforced club? Dude, these are just so bad compared to what we had, though. I'll take them, but like, we brought our sledgehammer. Ooh, what's this do? 20. I don't know. But anyways, this is the survival kit right here. We could have an SMG, but actually, the SMG does more damage than the pistol. What the hell? Really? You guys see that, right? Okay. I might just take the SMG anyway, because there's actually no point in not taking the SMG if it already does more damage. And we could upgrade it a little bit. Okay. We're going through some upgrades, ladies and gentlemen. First off, that flashlight has to come off you, Mr. Pistol. We are gearing up for some big stuff to happen here. The better SMG stock, you're going on. Better barrel, you're going on. I don't think I have a receiver or anything, but look at that. Quality's going up, and so's that damage. It does have way less block damage, but I don't know why you would care about block damage with an SMG. Oh, I didn't put the flashlight on it, or did I? Oh, no, I didn't. Let's do that. SMG. Most importantly, the flashlight. Equip you. I wonder how this thing looks with the flashlight. Looks pretty cool, actually, but yeah. We're doing some, like, Night Ops, James Bond, Saving Private, Star Stupid Booty. Because Star's booty got extra stupid today. I admit to that. I apologize for my stupidity, but hey, that's why you love me. You didn't sign up because I'm the smartest man in the world, and if you did, I don't know. What the hell made you think that? you know what? Just in case, we'll bring some gas over there, too. I think we needed some gas for our thing, but we'll leave the pistol behind. No point in taking that with. There's a point in taking the ammo. No point in taking those with. We're ready to roll, and we can upgrade the SMG when we get there. Hold on, I totally... Okay, never mind. We got a hell of a nice receiver to put on this thing, too. What's that damage at? 26? I'll take that. That is... Our SMG just got really nice. These upgrades? Hell yeah, okay. Operation Saving Private Star. We're gonna start in the night, but we're gonna roll. Now, I don't know how long this rolling process will take, but it's not gonna be a quick one. I'll tell you that right now. Hallelujah, at least we had the bare-bones setup to get some of this going. And by bare-bones setup, I mean... Well, first off, yeah, when I start running a little bit low, I'll drink the beer. But by bare-bones setup, I mean we had a gun, we had some... is this thing? No, didn't respawn. We had a solid gun, we had a flashlight for it. Like, I know we don't have armor, but we got some medical supplies. Like, things might seem pretty bad. They are pretty bad, I cannot deny that. But... we'll be able to recover. It's gonna... it really sucks. It really puts a sizable dent, a sizable little detour into our plans, but we should still be able to spend the rest of today over there in the new world. It is gonna be a bit of a hike. Definitely a bit of a hike. But there should be a ton of fun stuff along the way. But there's no way I could leave that body behind. Because that body's like our bank. 70 grand, 70 stacks, 70 something stacks, actually. And there's not the Lord of Shotgun Rain to save us, all right? There's no Lord of Light, no Lord of Shotgun Rain, there's nothing. You gotta go down, my friend. Oh no, I didn't reload. Ah! Parkour! That'll put a detour into you. Suck it, nerd. All right. Oh my god, that almost totally confused him. He's like, what is this car strat? There you go. Oh, this thing sounds silenced too. Sounds pretty cool. Yeah, but there you go. That's gonna be the game plan. And this thing has a bigger mag than our pistol. That's weird, though, that the SMG does more damage. I always thought the pistol would do more, but I guess not, so... I'm gonna invest in this SMG a little bit. Although, at the end of the day... at the end of the day, what the SMG, I think, is gonna be... it's gonna be our backup plan in case we ever do anything stupid. Case in point, about 5 to 10 minutes ago, what just happened. But also, just the ammo we stockpile for it. It's that emergency stockpile. But also we can armor turrets with it. So it's kind of a really good double whammy. Where it's like, it's not a good, like, we could use it as a really good primary weapon. But think about it. If we use it as a backup and we can just save up that ammo for other purposes too, it's really good. And our hike so far has been pretty good. I'd say we're about, what? That's like 1, 2, 3. We're about a fourth of the way there already. What's been like a minute? So it's going to be a little bit of a hike. And you might think to yourself, Star, Why would you subject us to such a hike? And the answer is, I'm not going to subject you guys to all of it. Just to some of it, right? To the exciting parts. But for now, that I'm finished talking about what I wanted to, we drank our beer, which will give us the rest of that stamina we need. We're going to head on over. And there's going to be some weird, like, dirt paths we could take. But I'm honestly might just end up taking, like, the sides of cliffs and stuff. And, dude, our athletics, with the amount of beer we're about to drink, yeah. This beer we're about to chug. It'll be very good, yeah, so good. But I was thinking maybe even going a little bit off-road. I might even shave off a little bit of time. So if we follow that to the T, it's gonna be pretty annoying to go through the side winding, but we can see where our backpack is. We can get there through the hills, and hey, maybe we'll find some good stuff through the hills. But yeah, I will talk to you guys in a little bit. Look at that views, boys and girls. I didn't fully appreciate this in a mini bike, I feel like, because right now, look at that. It's a gorgeous view. You know what's really cool? Oh, no, never mind. That path looks like it cuts through another layer of ocean. I know it's all the blocks loading in and stuff, but that looked really weird. Because I know that it should just be a lake over there. That should be land. Yeah, it's loading in super slow, but it looks like water from far away. Deer. Okay, so here's the deal. Right? Due to the fact that we lost so much wellness from our predicament here, we are gonna, in exchange... oh, I don't have a way to harvest the damn deer! Okay, well, deer, stay around these parts. You're safe for now. Maybe I'll even, like, pet you a little bit. You know, like, hello, deer, you're so adorable. Oh, good deer, good deer. Okay, I touched his butt a little. Hopefully he stays here. Because in exchange for the 10 wellness we just lost, like, we're not gonna get that time back. Right? Unfortunately, we won't get it back. Luckily for us, we're in such a good position where it's not that time segment we spent isn't a huge... it's not gonna be super bad. We're still in a really good position. But the one thing we lost that we actually have to work to get back is going to be our wellness. Our wellness went from a really high 117 down to 107. So in exchange, we got it. That's why I brought the hunting knife with us originally. We really have to try and just cash it. I might just go straight shot. Yeah, I might just straight shot there. We should hit the bridge. In exchange, we really have to try and hunt for some deer, get some meat. And from there, once we get home, that's why I want to start the farm. That's why I will start the farm. So we can make some meat stew. Or just, you know, use our eggs, make some bacon and eggs. And start up in our wellness again. Because our wellness has started to stagnate a little bit. Also, while we're out here, honestly, we got to run through a couple fields anyways. I might be picking up a couple of golden rods and whatnot. Because these things... Listen, if you guys... Golden rule of 7 days that I break sometimes. And also, it's kind of punny that I said it's the golden rule of 7 days. But golden rule of 7 days. Never pass by goldenrod. All right? If you are running past it, just take it in. Same with the red tea. Same with the chrysanthemums, except I can't pronounce that damn word no matter how hard you guys make me try. I cannot pronounce that word. Okay, I feel like sometimes I get it, but then the next time I will make it sound, it's like one time I say it right, like chrysanthemum. And then the next time I say like toilet paper and everyone's like star. That's not even close. And I'm just like, I thought it was close. It's not close. But yeah, chrysanthemums and goldenrod. Two things you should never pass up. Because what that does is it lets you make your water. You just gotta boil it up a little bit. It takes a little bit of wood. You know, maybe a little bit of coal. But at the end of the day, you know what it does? It gives you wellness every time you drink. And it makes that water give you more stamina than what you're used to. And also, we got the perfect amount of beer for our little expedition here. And I think we might actually time this perfectly. By the time we get back to our body, the store will be open for a little bit, and check this out. You know what's even better about this little shenanigans? The shenanigans still suck, don't get me wrong. But the good thing is, that's a new store. We have not checked out that store's stock yet. Maybe it'll have some good AK parts for us to upgrade our AK and whatnot. But, ooh, backpack, hello. Wooden club, no. Look at this beautiful water, though. Look at that. Look at that thing. What's going on there? You guys see that? I actually kind of like how the SMG looks with the silencer, though. It looks interesting. I do not like the fact that we're hot, though. We need to take a dip in water, but I might go ahead and end off the video here for now. We've been going for a good amount of time. Funnily enough, end off the video where we started it. We've come full circle, baby. We're going to finish looting up the quadruple gun stores when we return. In the meantime, though, I hope you guys have yourselves nothing but the most fantastic day in the world. Thank you a whole ton for hopping in. Thank you for watching. Thank you for hopefully making your own day better. Because, hey, like I said, if you're making your day better, that's making me happy. All right, I'll spread that positivity in the world. I like knowing there's a little bit more happiness in the world. So, yeah. But that's going to go ahead and wrap with me. Thank you guys a whole ton for watching. When we return, we will deal with this situation. Okay, we will. And let me know in the comment section as well the game plan you think. Like, do you want us to stay here overnight? Do you want us to not stay here overnight? What do you want us to do from here? What do you want the next steps in our journey to be? Even potentially after this whole fiasco, we still have to go home, and we still have a little bit of time before that day 35 horde. So as always, let me know what you guys want to see me do in the next episode, or in the next episodes, and I will take that into account as always. But in the meantime, stay beautiful, you amazing people. Stay awesome. Stay fan-freaking-tastic. Stay happy. Do all that jazz. Am I still running the right way? I'm still running the right way, yeah. And I'll talk to you guys in the next one. See ya.